Hello again. Well, they're together for their new single, and they're together, we know now, in real life. It's Delta Goodrum and Brian McFadden. An item here this morning. Morning to both of you. Right, first of all, the single, Almost Here. How did the two of you get together professionally, first of all, for this?
Well, it came around the time we were working on our two albums, because we worked at them with the same people, with Guy Chambers and...
And yours was Irish Sun, and yours was Mistaken Identity, the two albums, yeah.
So we were working on both of them, and I wrote this song that with a guy called Paul Barry, which I wanted to be a duet. So we started throwing around some different names, and we didn't really come up with anybody. And I was going home in the car, and I heard Delta. I didn't know who Delta was. I just heard the name, but I didn't know anything about her. And I heard one of her songs on the radio.
Yeah.
So I found out who it was. Rang my manager. He rang Sony, and they said, no, she doesn't do duets. You know, she wouldn't be interested. So I just made a demo and sent it straight to Australia to her people.
Yeah.
And a couple of days later.
Yeah, wait, sorry. Wait,
so if you didn't do duets, what made you want to?
No, I don't think it was. It was just like I wasn't really thinking about there was what was going on in my life. There was so much to talk about that I sort of felt like, why would I do a duet on my own? But then I realised how fantastic it would be to have a male vocal on my album. And not only that, I thought he had such a great voice, and the song was just like
so
really
you
special.
You used his vocal.
So I went, you know what, I'd love to be a part of this, and then I said, yeah, like, and we had a meeting, and then I went away to Australia for a while, then came back and recorded it.
All right, well, let's have a quick look. You're performing it later on, I know, in LK today, but let's have a quick look. Here it is, Almost Here. You know, when I knew you were in this morning, I thought, I'm sure this has been out before, and it's because we've all been talking about it for so long, because obviously you did the single, the video and all that sort of stuff, and then there were rumours in the paper that you were an item anyway. But now you are. When did that happen?
That was around the Royal Variety. I mean, I guess, you know, at the time when Brian and I first met...
Well, I was at that Royal Variety. Yeah. You didn't fall for me.
Sorry!
You sure you got the right Irishman?
I told you, I was not. No, well, you know, actually, when Brian and I first met again, there was, like, literally for an hour the first time we met, and just, I was had a lot of things going on in my life. Brian had, obviously, a lot of things going on in his life, and there was a lot of change that happened in that space of time.
And it must have been awkward, because everyone had talked so much about you being an item, that it must have been odd seeing each other.
It did, it was kind of weird, because I remember when we came to do the video shoot in London, and there'd been that week a couple of things in the paper, people, you know, putting us together. So we kind of turned up, and it was only, like, the second or third time we'd ever met, and it was such an awkward atmosphere in the video shoot because everybody was looking at us. So like we'd sit down and say, oh, how are you doing? And it was kind of like...
Really weird. We kind of had to, we became friends and we started working together.
And, and then you wore that dress to the Royal Variety Show and that apparently is what really grabbed Brian's attention. And what was it about that dress? And her, that night in particular. See, he's serenading you there, you're not looking very impressed.
Well, the song help you fall in love. Did it add to it at all?
Well, it's a breakup song. It's about people falling in love.
Well, what you need, of course, all you two need is another high-profile relationship after what you've been through. You must have thought about that.
Yeah, that's all.
Absolutely not.
No. You know what? You can't, I think you can't really decide what happens. You just sort of go, you know what, we're friends and we're enjoying each other's company at the moment and we're just going to, you know, enjoy it for now and then really just keep going with our work and...
Well, it must be an awkward situation for you because Brian's relationship has been so much in the press and you have the children and everything, Brian, as well. So how awkward has that been for you?
Well, you know what, again, I think that's Brian and his world that they sort of deal with. I really don't have anything to do with it, but I wish everybody happiness.
And it's early days yet, isn't
Absolutely.
It?
So. You know, we've got a great song and it's really exciting to be able to go around and talk about this song. So.
Yeah, all right. Well, Almost Here, we will hear it after 9 o'clock. Look forward to that and lovely to see the two of you together. Mm-hmm. Thank you very much.
See, they have given in to what you and I have resisted
all these years.
The high sexual tension.
I'll have to get. I'll have to get a dress like yours.
A dress.
Oh. It must be the dress. Would you fancy me in a dress like that?
I still tell you, she went for the wrong Irish guy to say that. Gorgeous man in that stage, but wrong.